So we now have a solution to the general thin airfoil series or thin airfoil theory, to that general equation or the fundamental equation. This is our solution here at the top, gamma of theta in terms of a Fourier sine series, and we know the coefficient of those series have to be equal to these terms here in general, and once we make a small angle approximation, they have to be equal to these coefficients over here. So let's use this information now to compute lift. So lift, the section lift, according to the Kutta-Joukowsky theorem, is equal to rho v infinity times gamma, capital gamma, where gamma is actually the integral of the of little gamma, or the vorticity strength of that sheet, from x not equal zero up to along the chord. So if we integrate gamma at x naught, dx naught, if we integrate that, then we get the total circulation here that is needed for the Kutta-Joukowsky theorem. So let's plug this in. And actually, first we want to do a change of variables here. So rho v infinity. We want to integrate in theta from theta naught equals zero up to pi of gamma of theta naught. And when we do that change of variables, there's an extra sine theta naught that shows up right here, d theta naught. And out front, we'll get a c over 2 when we do that change of variables as well. Okay, so there's our change of variables. That's the integral that we need to evaluate. And now we will simply plug this theta distribution, or excuse me, gamma distribution, into that equation. And so that will give us rho, we've got a v infinity squared now, because we had one up there that comes down, and then this 2 out front is going to cancel this 2 there. So we're left with rho v infinity squared times c, times the integral from theta naught equals zero to pi of a zero. And then we've got this 1 plus cosine theta, and that's evaluated at theta naught, and it's going to be multiplied by a sine theta naught, and we have a sine theta naught here in the denominator. This is also evaluated at theta naught, and so that will leave us with 1 plus cosine theta naught there, times d theta naught, plus, now we're going to have an infinite series from n equals 1 up to infinity, times a sub n, and we'll, inside of that we have, or move that integral inside of that, so theta naught equals 0 up to pi of sine n theta, n theta naught, multiplied by sine of theta naught, d theta naught. Okay, so that looks kind of nasty, but it turns out that this is rather simple. So the integral of from 0 to pi of 1 plus cosine theta is just pi. So this integrates to be just pi. And it turns out that this term over here, sine n theta times sine of theta d theta, integrated from 0 to pi, it turns out that that is pi halves whenever n is equal to 1, and 0 when n is not equal to 1. So all of these an terms that we were going to pass through here, as we were doing the summation of all these, well, it turns out that, this integral is zero for all of the terms except for n equals 1. So all we're left with is the a1 term there. So let's simplify this down now. So we've got L tilde is equal to rho v infinity squared c. And all we're left with in that first term is pi times a zero. And all we're left with in the second term is pi halves times a1. Okay, so that's our lift. And we can now write this actually in terms of the lift coefficient. The lift coefficient is L tilde over 1/2 rho V infinity squared times C. And so if we just take this equation for lift and divide it by the dynamic pressure times C, what we'll get there is 2 pi times a0 plus a1 over 2. Okay, so this is simplified quite a bit, and now what we need to do is we have these two terms here, a0 and a1, and the way we got to this equation is we used this general equation and plugged it in to our equation for lift, and then we non-dimensionalized that by dynamic pressure times C. And now let's plug in these small angle approximations for the for these two terms here, a0, and we only need a1, but we can now plug those in to this equation here and refine the solution a little bit further. So that's going to be equal to 2 pi times a0, which is alpha minus 1 over pi integral from theta equals 0 to pi of dyc dx d theta, and then we've got a plus a1 over 2. So let's see, a1 over 2. So we're going to look at a1 here, and it's got a 2 there that's actually going to cancel with the 2 there. So we're left with just a 1 over pi out front there, 1 over pi integral of from theta equals 0 to pi of dyc d x cosine of n theta d theta. Okay, and we need to close our parentheses there. And this can be simplified a little bit as well. So it turns out these two terms can be combined. We've got a 1 over pi times the integral of this dyc dx d theta. We've got a 1 over pi times the integral of dyc dx times cosine n theta, and so we can actually just rewrite that as 2 pi alpha minus 1 over pi times the integral from theta equals 0 to pi of dyc dx times 1 minus cosine theta d theta. Okay. Okay, so this is the equation for our lift coefficient. And usually the way that we write this is we say that the lift coefficient, CL, is equal to some lift slope, CL alpha, times alpha minus alpha L0, where the lift slope, CL alpha, is equal to 2 pi, and alpha L0 is equal to 1 over pi integral from theta equals 0 up to pi of dyc dx 1 minus cosine theta d theta. Okay, so this term right here is called our lift slope. And it's basically the change with respect to angle of attack. So you can see when we write the equation this way, we've got CL alpha, which is our lift slope, times alpha. And alpha L0 is actually a constant. Alpha L0 is independent of angle of attack. And so if you were to differentiate this equation with respect to alpha, you would be left with just this term out front, which from thin airfoil theory is 2 pi. So we're saying there's a lift slope multiplied by alpha of 2 pi from thin airfoil theory. And then this is called the zero lift angle of attack. So let's label that here. This is called the zero lift angle of attack. And basically, it tells us what angle the airfoil would be at to produce zero lift. So let's look at a plot here. What we're finding here is that thin airfoil theory says that the lift coefficient of this section as it relates to the angle of attack is going to be a straight line, and it's got a lift slope. The slope of that line is 2 pi, and it's going to cross the x-axis here, or the location, the angle of attack where our lift is equal to zero. This is alpha L0. This is the zero lift angle of attack. So there's a lot we can learn here just about the lift from thin airfoil theory, that roughly our lift is going to go up in a linear fashion. As we increase our angle of attack, our lift will increase linearly, and it will increase at a rate of 2 pi. That's the constant we get out here from thin airfoil theory. And we're going to find that that's not exactly right, but it's actually really quite really close for most airfoils, especially thin airfoils, that they do have a lift slope of 2 pi. And we're also going to find that we can locate where our lift will go to zero. In other words, what angle of attack will be needed in order for that lift to be exactly zero on the airfoil. And that's related, that's the zero lift angle of attack here. That depends on the slope of our camber line. So let's just look at an example here real quick. If the slope of our camber line were zero, meaning that we had a symmetric airfoil, so let's just draw a symmetric airfoil over here. Okay, so there's our symmetric airfoil, and the slope of the camber line is zero. I meant to draw that camber line right along the x-axis like that. So if there's no slope in our camber line, what this is saying, so this term will be zero, meaning that the zero lift angle of attack is zero. That means that at 0 degrees angle of attack, we will produce zero lift on this airfoil here, which makes sense, right? If we have a symmetric airfoil top to bottom, then if we have zero angle of attack, if the flow is coming in horizontally, then the pressure on the top of this airfoil will be equal to the pressure on the bottom, and so we will get no net lift on this airfoil, meaning that the lift coefficient will be zero. But if we increase the angle of attack, now we have the flow coming in at an angle, the lift will increase by a factor, by a slope of 2 pi. Okay, so we've now looked at the lift. Let me just box a couple of these equations. This is a very important expression here, and we'll be using this a lot to evaluate the performance of an airfoil. And basically what we found here is that all we need is the camber line. We can differentiate that camber line, take the integral of that across the chord. That will tell us the zero lift angle of attack. And then we know that thin airfoil theory says that our lift will increase at a rate of 2 pi per radian, per angle of attack in radians.